This is Nwanyi Afikpo talking to the squad of USO, Uchechukwu Samson Oga of Masters Energy Oil, who is the guba, the sole aspirant. The rest are behind the scene aspirants. This man is the sole aspirant. He is the one that has been suffering, doing everything possible that anybody who is running for anything should do. It's USO that we know. And USO has been campaigning all his life in a way, because what this man is doing in Igbo land is better seen. It's better imagined than even seen, because I don't even know how to put it. It's really incredible. I have never seen a man like this man in my 44 years of living. I've never known anybody like USO. Afikpo people, do you know how I behave in Afikpo? Okay. I am a tiny version of USO. That is why they do for Afikpo, why they give 2,000 here, 10,000 here, 11,000 here. USO is a big version of it. You can just imagine. It's only Afikpo that will even understand what I'm talking about. And Uturu already understands, because their man is doing it in the highest level, level possible. Well, USO fans are very worried, extremely worried. I get inboxes telling me that they will bomb TA. I say, make una no write me this kind to you. Make SS no come carry me. They will bomb this if TA carry this thing, give him crony or whatever. They will do this. In short, they're worried, they're crying. And these are his brothers. This is the young, the one that looks exactly like USO is the younger brother, same mother, same father. And the one that is in my house now intimidating me, I hear he's a very big man, but he's his cousin, real cousin. What is your name, sir?
I'm Chief Onyekwere.
Chief
Onyekwere.
Guys, let me tell you something. Since the guy came into this house, I've not felt comfortable. He looks like a big man, he's a big man, and he acts it. So you have to listen to him when he talks. And USO's brother, what's your name?
Chief Amobi Oga.
Chief Awo?
Amobi.
Amobi Oga. Okay, Chief Amobi Oga. And the third one is Chief who?
Daniel.
Again, I have to ask again, who are you to me, to USO, to Sir USO?
I'm his personal assistant.
Okay, and where are you from, sir?
I'm from Uturu.
Okay, so you are the brother also.
Yeah,
yes. All right, let's start with the big man. Let's start with him. Please talk to USO fans, because they are very, very worried. Talk to them. What do you have to say to them to calm their nerves?
All right, thank you so much. This issue of governorship is not an easy thing. So everybody have to cool down and be prayerful. But we believe in God that come May 2015, we are going to take the seat of Abia State.
Amen.
God is on our side.
Amen.
This man called USO, he's coming out to salvage Abia State.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I've never known such a man.
To redeem Abia State.
Absolutely.
This man has made money.
Absolutely.
If you need 100 convoys, you can get it.
Uh-huh. 2 million convoys.
Even jets, anything you can think
3
of.
3 billion jets, he will get
this
it.
This is a man that has been managing his firm with 13 subsidiaries.
Absolutely.
He has excelled in his business.
Yes.
He's not coming there to rip Abia State.
Anybody else.
Rather, he's
coming
there to make Abia a town that be more comfortable to
a first to be reckoned with, a first state.
So they should pray, they should cool down.
Okay, you've heard it.
Taking the seat.
You've heard it. The big man says, cool down, that everything is going to be all right. Let's speak to Damion. This is the PA. He also runs a group called TAD Initiative, True Abians for
Development.
What do you have to say? Calm USO fans down, because as you know, they are going crazy.
As a political scientist, there is something we know. There are measures when election is closing in, they call propaganda. People use every device they put to make sure they demoralize the followers of a particular person. But USO, we are not worried. We want to tell you something. Whatever you read on the net, maybe co-aspirants are doing, it's normal. But after the primary election, we are picking the ticket. Contact 30th, the result shall be announced in Afikpo.
Amen.
We will pick it, not by rigging.
Amen.
The ground will have to pick
it. Amen.
It is your vote we are talking about.
Amen.
And also, as
the people's choice.
If you've had contact with him, you should be able to tell that there are qualities of leadership in him.
Absolutely.
This is not just a man who
came. A man of sympathy.
He has never loved politics. He's somebody I followed over time. Never loved politics. He came into politics because he saw the face of Abia.
Absolutely.
Who've been smiling, suffering, living in a particular state. Though TA must have done his best, we will say TA laid the foundation. So USO is coming to set up the building.
The building, all
so
right.
At the end of the day, you shouldn't be worried.
Okay.
You will have your mind as the governor.
All right. The personal assistant of USO is telling you guys not to worry that everything is going to be all right. They are not going to steal this from USO because that's what you're worried about. No one is going to steal it. If they, how can they steal this now? How now? God has given us this man. This man, I've never seen such a man in my entire life. And I've seen men. I have seen, you know, I know, say, I don't, you know, say, when I know who I be now, what I never see. And as they tell you, this man is unlike no other man. This man is a blessing to Igbo land. Now, we are going to talk to USO's younger brother, who looks, who shockingly, eerily looks exactly like him. It's scary. So, please, USO's brother, what do you have to say to the fans? Because they are just going mad, as you can see. You go to the page of USO, right? You see what they're saying. They are worried.
Well, what I can tell our fans, because Uche is me, and I'm Uche because he's my brother.
Yes.
And there are days that says nothing good comes so easy.
Yes.
We don't expect that it will be so easy for USO to be a governor of Abia State. Yeah. Knowing where he's coming from, knowing where the idea he's bringing it to. You know, it's exactly what happened in Akwa Ibom that is about to happen in Abia State. Because I'm telling our fans that comment.
Excuse me, can you explain this Akwa Ibom matter? Because it was this guy that installed
It was not Atta that installed Abadio.
I didn't know Abadio that. Can you explain
not
it?
Atta's candidate. Yes.
I didn't know this. So.
Yes. And that is why today Abadio have proven to be the people's choice. And that is what USO is about to do.
I didn't know that.
So I am telling our fans that nothing good comes so easy. Let's keep praying and hoping that what God has destined to Abia will come to pass.
Amen. Amen.
Okay.
Thank you so much, USO brothers.
Okay. It was so the fans, as you, by the way, you know, a woman likes to do cup at all times. I don't get any cup. I didn't prepare for this. Now you can put your mind to rest. You don't have to worry anymore. Don't send me any inbox mail of bombing anybody because they will just come and pick me up wherever I am. So just cool down. As the brothers have told you, everything is going to be all right. USO is working 24/7 to make sure that what belongs to you comes to you. To make sure that nobody removes the sugar from your mouth.
Yes, so.
So please just cool down. USO will be okay. And another thing is they feel sorry for USO. They feel everybody is mistreating him. No one is mistreating USO. Is anyone mistreating
USO? No. No, that is why I'm telling them that nothing good comes so easy. They don't expect it that it will be so easy for him to do
government. Being number one man in a state, it's not easy.
It's not easy.
Like what Jonathan now, he's not battling his own.
Yes.
It's not easy.
So
you guys have to calm down and pray for it, yeah?
Okay. All right, thank you guys very much. I'm going to post this tomorrow. And you have me to thank for having the privilege of meeting these three wonderful people that came here just to plead with you to calm down that everything will be all right. Thank you guys. Bye.
Thank you.
USO, wait. USO 2015.
I'm going to rejoice.
USO 2015.
I'm going to rejoice.